In this video, we're finding the angle between the reflected and refracted rays as light enters water. So we're going for this big angle right here. And I can start real quick using the law of reflection and say that that angle must be 45 degrees. The reflected angle is equal to the incident angle. The one that's more challenging is the refracted angle. I'll call that theta r. And then I can see that all three of these angles add up to 180 degrees. So there's a little trig calculation to do at the end. To get theta r, we use Snell's law. And we'll say the air is material 1 and the water is material 2. We're told the index of refraction of air is about 1. So I'm going to plug that in. And then sine of theta 1, which is the incident angle of 45 degrees here. The index of refraction of water is 1.33. And then sine of theta 2, which I'll call theta r, the refracted angle. So I divide by 1.33 on both sides and then invert the sine function to solve for theta r. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 32.1 degrees for the refracted angle. Now I'll label the angle between the reflected and refracted rays as theta. And we just have to do a quick calculation to find theta. I know that all three of these angles add up to 180 degrees. So 45 plus theta plus my refracted angle, 32.1 degrees. Is equal to 180. Into three sig figs, I get 103 degrees for the angle between the reflected and refracted rays. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.